الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم إنك أنت الأعز الأكرم. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم والطف بنا بما جات به المقادير يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل هذا القرآن نور صدورنا وربيع قلوبنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا. اللهم علمنا منه ما جهلنا وذكرنا منه ما نسينا واجعله اللهم حجة لنا لا حجة علينا. Dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Surat al-Shams is the surah, inshallah, we are going to attempt to explain and do tafsir for, is one of the early Meccan revelation, beginning with a very fine nature passage leading up to people's need of realizing their spiritual responsibility. It also puts right the relationship of man with the creation of Allah, the Creator. It ends with a warning of the terrible consequences for those who fear not the hereafter. Please join me to explore the magnificence of Surat al-Shams. So we established that Surat al-Shams is an early Meccan surah, and also it looks at the relationship with people, with man, and the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as people who deviated from the message of prophets, worshipped the sun and the moon and the stars. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is directing our attention to the magnificence of His creation, and hence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one to be worshipped. Inshallah, we first recite a surah by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then inshallah we come to its tafsir. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها. الحمد لله رب العالمين. It was recorded that in the two Sahihs, that is Al-Bukhari and Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told Mu'adh, when he prayed a very long prayer leading the people, that pray with Sabbih isma rabbika al-a'la, glorify the name of your Lord, wash-shamsi wa duhaha, and by the sun and its brightness, and also layli idha yaghsha, by the night as it envelopes. So it was one of the surahs that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam recommended Mu'adh to read instead of reading a very long prayer. Mu'adh was directed to read سبح اسم ربك الأعلى والشمس وضحاها and والليل إذا يغشى. These of course are examples. I'd like to emphasize also here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah and in many other surahs, particularly Meccan surahs, are directing our attention to the glory of His creation. And if the creation is glorious, then the Creator is far more glorious. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ghafir, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارُ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ لَا تَسْجُدُوا لِلشَّمْسِ وَلَا لِلْقَمَرِ وَاسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُنْ إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. Among the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we said that the word ayah in Al-Quran, at least it means one of three things. One is a verse of Al-Quran, ayah in a surah. The second is a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is the Creator, He is the Lord, He is glorious. And these signs are all around us, the sun, the moon, our own creation, the animal kingdom, the plants, the rain, the seas, the universe. All of these are signs of the glory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is the Creator and He is worthy of being worshipped. And the third meaning of ayah is the miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala equip His messengers and prophets to prove to people that they are sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and indeed to challenge them. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts by an oath, and the oath goes on for many ayat. It starts وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by the sun. It is an oath, and again an oath is to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the creator, in this case of the sun. And والقمر والنهار والليل, the night and the day, all of these are creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath to elevate the importance and also to draw our attention to His creation, this glorious creation. As the ayat I recited or mentioned in Surat Ghafir, among His signs, ayatihi, al-laylu, the night, the day, the sun and the moon, do not prostrate to the sun nor to the moon, and prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created them. So again, in my opinion, that these surahs that start with an oath by the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to tell people that it is the creator of these objects, of these creations, albeit magnificent and great, but also a reflection that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, is magnificent and He is great and He is able to create what He wills. And also these are favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to His creation, to us. So we need to remember His favors. Also the oath gives significance to the subject of the oath, why there is an oath, as we will see as we have seen in previous surahs, and also as we will see inshallah in this surah. So وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا, وَالشَّمْسِ, and by the sun and its brightness. ضُحَاهَا, now ضُحَاهَا can mean a brightness, it can mean splendor of the sun, also it can mean the time of duha. And the time of duha is when the sun is high enough, about 15 to 20 minutes from sunrise, then that is called al-duha. Al-duha is that time, so it's about 15 to 20 minutes from sunrise until just before midday, about 15 or 20 minutes from midday. That time is called al-duha. And as you know, there is a very important nafil, which is salat al-duha. That is, it suffices the one who prays al-duha from paying charity from every joint they have, as in the hadith. So it could be the oath by the sun and that time, al-duha. It could be, and of course, during that time, al-duha, the sun, if it is not cloudy, is very visible, and it is very bright, and it is to be seen compared with the time of just sunrise. It is rising or it is setting. So the sun is in the middle of the sky. It is visible, it is bright, and it is giving the warmth and the energy to earth. And وَضُحَاهَا, as again remind you, is that time after sunrise and just before midday is الضحى, or it is the brightness, an oath by the brightness of the sun, or it is an oath by its splendor, because it is a magnificent thing to have. وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا, and by the moon as it follows it. وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا, and also by the moon. So the oath goes on, and as we know, the oath, there are letters of the oath, the waw, as here, وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرِ, and the ta, tallah, and the ba, billah. These are the letters for an oath. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath by the moon as it follows the sun. It follows, إذا تلاها, when the sun sets, then the moon is most visible. We know that even when the sun is in the middle of the sky, you could see the moon, for sure. And also there are times where the sun is setting, and it is the time that you see the crescent, the birth of the moon, and it is very difficult sometimes to sight the moon because you are looking directly into the direction of the sun. And as you all aware, Islam, there are many rituals in Islam that are based on the movement of the sun and also the moon. The beginning of months are by sighting the moon. For example, Ramadan and Shawwal is the beginning of the month after Ramadan, which begins with the day of Eid al-Fitr, the celebration for breaking the fast. And also the moon is important to follow up all the 12 lunar months in Islam. There are some of these, for example, Dhul Hijjah is when Hajj is performed. And Ash-Shams is also our five prayers. follow the sun. So al-fajr is the time before sunrise. It starts about 90 minutes or so. That is the al-fajr. And when the sun is perpendicular or it is in the middle of the day, then it is the beginning of dhuhr. And when the shadow is the length of the object or two lengths, depending on the school of jurisprudence, then it is asr. And when it sets, it is maghrib. And after maghrib, about 90 minutes, when it is dark, then it is isha. So again, I remind you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this creation for a purpose, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also these objects are vital to our life. The sun, for example, and again, this is an argument against those who they find it difficult to understand the scientific miracles of Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Of course, there are conditions and there are ways of going into that direction. But in my opinion, these ayat are very much into science. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath by the sun, then people would know what is a sun. They know its purpose, they know its importance, they know that it gives them warmth, etc. So at the very basic level of understanding and relationship to the sun, for example, people can appreciate the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then if you take that to even more knowledge, those who are specialized, then they will appreciate the sun even more. For example, if we talk about the sun very, very briefly, dear brothers and sisters, the sun is considered to be the center of the solar system. Again, I say that this is not tafsir, but this is the way that people should be thinking while reading Al-Quran Al-Kareem. You need to relate to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath by the sun, then you know how important the sun is. But the more knowledge you have regarding the sun, the more you appreciate such an oath and such a great creation, a magnificent creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and hence feeling the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that He is the Lord, and that He, all the favors we have from Him, and He is Allah to be worshipped and none to be worshipped beside Him or with Him, so He needs to be worshipped alone. So it is the center of the solar system, around which all the planets, moons, comets, and asteroids orbit the sun's the sun's heat and light are essential for life. Without the warmth and the light of the sun, so the sun has energy, the warmth, as well as the light, which is again energy that makes it easy for us to see during the day and do our jobs during the day. And nowadays we generate energy from the sun, which is something perhaps many, many decades ago people didn't do. So that is even more, gives us more appreciation to such a great creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The equator circumference of the sun is 4,379,000 kilometers. That is the circumference of the equator. So that is the largest distance around the sun. Its radius is short of 700,000 kilometers. The temperature of the sun varies from just below 6,000 degrees centigrade at the surface to about 15 million degrees centigrade towards the core of the sun. The average orbital speed around the Milky Way of the sun is 720,000 kilometers per hour. That is 200 kilometers per second. And it is considered, the sun is a star, considered to be a yellow dwarf. Average time taken to rotate on axis is 27 Earth days. Number of planets is also known to us. So, dear brothers and sisters, of course, we can talk a lot more about that, the distance from Earth, how the weight of the sun, the relationship in size between the sun and the Earth, and so on and so forth. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes such an oath, we need to remember that. And hence, this is a Meccan surah, and yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is projecting the people, the followers of Islam and the faithfuls and the Muslims, they are projected into the future and into appreciating the creation of Allah. And science is for sure, it's the subject of science is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So at the end of the day, the scientists are studying the creation of Allah, from the sun to the moon to the planets to the stars to the galaxies and so on, and also those who look into the human body in terms of medicine, and those the botanists look at, into plants and the biologist biology, they look into the biology of the body, or they look at animals and birds, etc. So all of that is the creation of Allah, and it is the subject of scientists. So this is indeed a way to look into these ayat, to appreciate the creation of Allah and to link into his creation. The same can be said about the moon. The moon is one of the most recognizable objects in the solar system. This proximity to Earth, its proximity to Earth has given its cultural significance, and it means it plays a key role in Earth's tides. So when you, if you go to the sea and you see low tide and high tide, you need to understand that this is because of the gravity of the moon, and without the moon, then you may not have that, and you may not even have the life on Earth. It is extremely important. The equator circumference is just under 11,000 kilometers. Its radius is 1.737 kilometers, so 1,737. Average distance from Earth, because the moon, it is elliptical, it goes around the Earth in an elliptical manner. The average distance is 384,400 kilometers. Its temperature varies between plus 127 degrees centigrade, which is above boiling point, to minus 173 degrees centigrade, which you will not find such temperatures on Earth. Average orbital speed is 3,683 kilometers per hour. Day length and year length is equal 27 days. It is a rocky planet. And you can also size the moon compared with the Earth. So all of that, again, is to encourage us to look into the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appreciate His creation, and appreciate the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, it is talking about this in details. You may find in some of the tafsirs and the scholars in the past, for example, it is very much agreed that the earth is round. The earth is spherical. It is not flat as a piece of flat earth. So you will find even Ibn Taymiyyah talking about the agreement among the scholars that it is so. Also, you'll find, if you look into Ibn Kathir, you'll find that it is very clear for Ibn Kathir in his tafsir that the sun is burning, is like a lamp that produces energy and it is burning, and the moon is merely a reflection of the brightness of the sun. So you'll find that the scholars have known that many centuries ago. Nevertheless, the Quran talks about these creations, so as we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. We acknowledge His favors, and also to worship Him, and to worship Him alone, not to worship the sun nor the moon, but to make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator. So how Islam is tying up the tawheed, monotheism, with modern science as known today, and as it was known a century ago or even centuries before that. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا, and by the day as it shows up. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا. Now, جَلَّاهَا, the pronoun here, it goes to the sun, because وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا. So all the pronouns here are referenced back to the sun. So وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also makes an oath by the day. And during and jallaha means that the sun during the day is very visible, it is very clear, it is there for us to see and appreciate, and also to use in terms of warmth, in terms of doing our jobs mostly during the day, and nowadays also we plan our solar energy to be facing the sun in the area we are in. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا. جَلَّاهَا made it clear. جَلِي means clear. جَلَاءُ الشَّيْء, it means that it is clear, it is visible. There is no doubt about it. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا. So النَّهَارِ will, the day will show the brightness of the sun. It will give it its worth of brightness, warmth, and light. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا, and by the night as it conceals it. So وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا, اللَّيْل, subhanallah, is when the sun is on the other side, and then the earth is shadowing it. So it is yaghshaha, and yaghshaha means it conceals it. So here, even in the Quran, it says that it conceals it. So it is there, it hasn't gone, it is still there, but we are unable to see it. And we know nowadays how the mechanism and the rotation of the earth around the sun and the moon, etc., how that works, and also eclipses, whether that is sun eclipse or moon eclipse, we know all of that. Well, layli idha yaghshaha, and by the night that it conceals the sun. وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making an oath by the sun and by the moon, the day and the night. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about as-sama, heaven. And as-sama in Arabic language is everything that is above you. So as-sama is not only what we see. It is as-sama. There are, as we are told, there are seven heavens. The heaven we see, the universe around us, which is billions, 13 or so billion light years across. Of course, that is what we know today. Tomorrow we will know more. Perhaps we know that it is bigger. Allah knows best. All of that is in the first heaven, and there are heaven after heaven until we have the seventh heaven. And I'm sure perhaps you remember the hadith of the size of these heavens in relation to one another, that the first heaven compared with the second one is like a ring thrown into the desert, and the second into the third, and the third into the fourth, etc., is the same compared with one another, is like a ring thrown into the desert. So you can understand the magnitude of as-sama, heaven, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala built. The word banaha is the same word you use to when you build a house or you build a structure. Was-sama'i wa ma banaha is it can mean one of two things. Was-sama'i wal-ladhi banaha, it means by the heaven and by the one who built the heaven, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also it can mean was-sama'i and the way it was built. So it is an oath by heavens and by the constructor of the heaven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or it is an oath by heavens and by its structure that is built by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is, even if we look at the universe around us, of course, the sun, the moon are in the backyard of the earth compared with the universe, the large universe with many systems, with very complex structure. Even today, the scientists and the scholars look into the energy that is there and calculate, and they find that there is an energy that they cannot calculate from for example, the relationship between the stars and the planets, etc. Hence, they come up with things like other types of energy, which they do not know where they come from. I'm sure if you are interested, you can follow up with that, if that is your area. والسماءِ وما بناها والأرضِ وما طحاها, and by the earth and him who spread it. Now طحاها, I'm sure you remember دحاها, أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها. So طحاها and dahaha, the ta and the dal are close, although the ta is mufakham, is thick letter, but they mean very the meanings of the two are very close. So wal ardi wa ma tahaha, so it gives you at least two meanings. The first meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, although the earth is a globe, as a globe, but for us it is easy to travel across. It is spread out for us. It is easy for us to live on. It is easy for us to travel between city and city, between a point or another point on earth. That is one meaning. The other meaning is akhraja minha ma'aha, akhraja minha ma'aha wa mar'aha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made the earth also the source of our sustenance. أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us from earth the water, and the water either is inside the earth which comes, or it is in rivers. But ultimately, the seas that with the sun's heat, there is evaporation and then condensation and then rain. So it is a renewable source of water for. And this has been for centuries and centuries. People always had water on earth, and this water comes from the oceans. They are salty, so as it is suitable for fish and marine life to live, but also it keeps the water in good condition. Then the sun, and of course there are other factors of evaporation, such as the spread of the surface of the water resource, it is the wind, etc. All of that cause evaporation and then condensation, because the higher layers are colder, and then that condensation ultimately forms the water which comes down. There are also in Surat An-Nur elaborate explanation how that happens, and in Surat Ar-Rum as well. So in Surat An-Nur and in Surat Ar-Rum, inshallah, if Allah gives enough life, we may inshallah come to these surahs and explain that. Wal ardi wa ma tahaha, so tahaha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it in a way that it is livable to be on, and also akhraja minha ma'aha wa mar'aha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made its rizq from within, and that rizq, that sustenance is also renewable. All the plants we eat, and we drink the water, and the animals eat it, and we eat the animals, and all of that is renewable, and it has been since the beginning of time when man arrived on earth. ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also makes an oath by a nafs. Now, you may find in some of the tafaseer or some of the translations, nafs is a reference to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam as the first human, and he was the first human to come down on earth and to live on earth with his wife that was created from him. But really, there is no need to be so specific and say that wa nafsin here is Adam, but nafs is general, so it applies to all souls, to all humans, including Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and the beginning of time. And of course, Adam, he is the father of all human beings. We all relate to him. We are all brothers and sisters from that sense and from that viewpoint. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath, وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. So that, and the soul, nafs is not, there is, you will find that there is always an argument and discussion among scholars about the meaning of a nafs. A nafs, it can mean the soul, but also it is a reference to the human, man or woman. So that the whole thing is a nafs, including the soul inside the body. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we take that direction and that tafsir, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making an oath by the individuals, by the humans that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected its creation. وَمَا سَوَّاهَا, perfected it from all viewpoints. The soul, the body is perfect, the vision, the hearing, the limbs, the digestive system, the heart, the blood going round, and the hormones, and the very, very complex networks inside the body, including the soul, that is an energy in it. But also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave directions to the humans, to that nafs, to this soul, to that person. So it is not only a body and a spirit, but it is a there are feelings, there are mental abilities, there are instincts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala installed in ourselves. That even a newborn, they have that instinct to live and to be attached to the mother and to suck the milk. And later on in life, there are values that people agree upon, and these are installed in us with the creation. And hence, you will find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. So, وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath by the soul, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected that soul and that the human soul and body and mental abilities and instincts and values installed even without teaching people. There are things that people believe and understand, even belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that yuladu al-mawludu ala al-fitra, that a person is born to believe in Allah, in one creator, and to believe that he is worthy of worship and know that creator. And then the society or the community or the may distort that originality, if you like, in the humans. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired that human with فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instilled in the human the knowledge of bad and good, the direction to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the direction away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fujuraha wa taqwaha. And also that is similar to وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ, as in the previous surah, in Surat Al-Balad, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave choice to people, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them able to distinguish between what is evil and what is good, what is harmful and what is benefit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his wisdom, gave us the free will to choose and to follow the path and the way people see. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent prophets and messengers and books to tell people that if they follow the truth, if they follow the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if they are on the straight path, as-sirat al-mustaqim, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they shall live a decent life, a happy life on earth, and they will be rewarded by a paradise in the hereafter that they dwell there forever and ever. And if they deviate and choose the path of evil and the path of immorality and the path of being away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it is punishment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threatens with. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Al-fujur is really to go beyond the limit in immorality and to transgress in worshipping beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people or animals or things or what have you, including the sun or the moon. So that is fujur, is to exceed the limit, particularly when it comes to worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَقْوَاهَا. التَّقْوَى is from prevention, from avoidance. So they avoid the bad things, the evil behavior, and all the immoralities, and they avoid to worship anything beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. Indeed, he succeeds who purifies his own self, and indeed he fails who corrupts his own self. Inshallah, we stop here. We continue with that thought and with these two ayat next week, by the will of Allah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us enough life. Barakallah fikum. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you very much for your presence and for attending and for listening and see and having apportioned time to listen to this tafsir. May Allah accept from all of us. May Allah guide us. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidun Majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alamin innaka Hamidun Majid. See if there are any questions, do send them. Even if you send them later, I will answer them, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.